Students, today we discuss our unit first, that is matter in our surrounding. So this is our unit first. That unit is a part of chemistry. So before discussing this unit, so firstly we discuss what is chemistry. It is that branch of science which deals with the study of matter. So basically, what is chemistry? It is the study of matter. So in chemistry, we study the nature of matter. The composition of matter and the different properties of matter. So these are the three points which are explained by chemistry. Means chemistry tells us about the nature of matter, its composition and its property. Now the question arises in our mind, that is, what is matter? Anything that has some mass and occupies space, that is called as matter. Means anything that has some mass and that occupies space, that is called as matter. Now the question arises, you learn, listen two words. One is mass, another is weight. There are two words come in our mind, that is, one is mass and another is weight. What is the difference between mass and weight? You know that the mass is represented by m and the weight is represented by mg. And the second thing, here g represent the gravity, acceleration due to gravity. Okay? Mass is same everywhere. The mass remains same everywhere. But weight varies with the position. Or you can say location. Suppose if we take the example on moon and earth, the weight is not same, but mass remains same. Suppose a person having mass 15 kg. So mass remains same on moon or as well as earth. But the gravity of moon is g by 6 of that of earth. The gravity of moon is g by 6 of that of earth. So the weight of moon is different from that of earth. Now the third point. The unit of mass is kg. And the unit of weight is Newton. So these are the few differences between mass and weight. So this is matter, that is anything that have mass, some mass and occupies space, that is called as matter. Now the second question arises on our mind, that is classification of matter. Classification of matter. Matter can be classified in two ways. One is physical classification and the second is chemical classification. There are two ways on the basis of which we can classify the matter. One is physical classification and another is chemical classification. Okay. So on the next slide, we discuss about the classification of matter. So, all clear? Now come to the classification of matter. If you have any doubt, let me know. So now firstly we discussed about the physical classification of matter. The classification that is based on physical properties of matter is known as physical classification. Means the classification that is done on the basis of physical properties. What are those physical properties? What are those physical properties? The physical properties are size, shape, volume, density, compressibility. So these are the various physical properties on the basis of which we can classify the matter. If we classify the matter on the basis of these property, then the types of matter is of three type. One is solid, second is liquid, and the third one is gas. There are two states of matter, additional states of matter. One is plasma, another is Bose-Einstein condensate. These are the two additional states of matter, but they are of very little importance for us. We discuss it later. Okay. So here we discuss these three types. One is solid, another is liquid, and the third one is gas. What is solid? The first point, if you write the difference between solid, liquid and gas, so there are lots of differences between solid, liquid and gas. The first one is fixed shape. Solid always have a fixed shape and fixed volume. The shape and volume of solids is always fixed. If we take the example of a brick, you can never change the shape of brick without breaking it. The volume of brick is also fixed. Okay. If we talk about liquid, not a fixed shape. Not a fixed shape, but volume is fixed. When we discuss about liquid, liquid have a fixed volume. Suppose if we have 1 liter milk, it remains 1 liter. If we took it from Karnataka, from Delhi or from Rohtak. Okay? So the volume of liquid is always fixed, but the shape of liquid is never fixed. Suppose if we take liquid in a bowl, it takes the shape of bowl. If we take in a beaker, it takes the shape of beaker. If we take it in liquid in glass, take the shape of glass. Now discuss about gas. Not fixed shape, not fixed volume. The shape and volume of gas is not fixed. I explained it to you. Suppose we take a small room and we fill gas in this small room. Now, what is the volume of this gas present in this small room? it will equal to the volume of the room because gas occupies the space available to it. Okay. So now the volume of gas in this small room is equal to the volume of the room, and the shape of the gas is equal to the shape of that room. Suppose now we remove the gas from this small room and fill that gas in a big room. Now the room, the gas will take the shape of that big room, and the volume of the gas is also equal to the volume of the big room. So from this experiment it is clear that the volume and shape of gas is not fixed. Clear to all of you? Okay. Now the third point, not compressible.